Hello friends, this video on rational numbers part 8 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So let us now talk about some of the properties of rational numbers. Now you might ask that why do we need to learn about these properties? We will also get back to that a little later. So first let us look at the properties. These are the properties that we will consider: closure property, commutative property, associative property, distributive property. Now these properties are not only true for rational numbers, these properties exist also for integers and natural numbers and whole numbers. So these exist for them as well. And I am sure that you have studied about natural numbers, whole numbers and integers in your junior classes, so you already know about these properties for those numbers. Now we are going to talk about the same properties but for rational numbers. We will also learn how to find out reciprocal of a number, how to find out additive, inverse or negative of a number. So let's start one by one. So we will first start with closure property. Now the closure property says that, now again, the closure property exists for different operations. Like the closure property exists for addition of rational numbers, it exists for subtraction of rational numbers, multiplication as well as division of rational numbers. So as for the closure property for addition, it says that sum of two rational numbers is always a rational number. So if you have any two rational numbers, let's say A and B are two rational numbers, then the sum of A and B will always be a number which is again a rational number. So as per this, so therefore we say that rational numbers are closed under addition. Closed means they do not allow any other numbers to come in. So two rational numbers add to form a rational number again. So they remain closed within their group. So it is something like this. Let's say we say that the doors of your house are closed for people other than your friends. So that means if anybody else comes to your house, the doors will not open. They will not be allowed to enter. But if your friends come, they are allowed to enter. Right? So that means you are closed. So you are basically closed for a certain people. So once you have those people in place, you do not entertain anybody else. So the same thing is true here. These rational numbers, they are closed under addition. That means for addition property, they do not allow any other type of number to entertain. They just allow the rational numbers. So they add up to form only rational numbers. Similarly, when you talk about the difference, that is their subtraction, that is when you subtract two rational numbers, whatever you get is always a rational number again. So we say that rational numbers are closed under subtraction as well. When you talk about the product, that when you multiply two rational numbers, you again get a number which is also a rational number. So that means the rational numbers are closed under product. Division of two rational numbers may or may not be a rational number. That means A divided by B is equal to C. Now this C may or may not be rational. Therefore, we would say that rational numbers are not closed under division. So the best example that tells you that dividing two rational numbers may not be a rational number is whenever you divide any rational number by zero, because zero is also a rational number. But when you divide one rational number by zero, what do you get? You get something like not defined, because anything by zero is not defined. So not defined is again not a rational number. So that is why we say that rational numbers are not closed under division. So let us now talk about each of these properties one by one. So first we will look at closure property of addition. So here let us take examples and then understand how this property holds true. So as per closure property, we say that sum of two rational numbers is always a rational number. So let us take examples of two rational numbers. Let's say we consider A as 3 by 5 and we consider B as 6 by 9, where A and B are two rational numbers. So the sum of A and B would be 3 by 5 plus 6 by 9. So this would be equal to 27 plus 30 divided by 45. So that's how we add such numbers. So this would come out to be 57 by 45. Now, when you look at 57 by 45, is it a rational number? This is in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0. So this is a rational number. And that is why we say that rational numbers are closed under addition. So we can say that a plus b is equal to c, where c is always a rational number. Now you can try this out taking any other example. You just take any two rational numbers, add them, you will always get a rational number. Similarly, let us look at the closure property of subtraction. So here again, we take two rational numbers. Let's say we say a is equal to 3 by 5 and b is equal to 9 by 2. So now if you calculate the difference of the two, that is a minus b, so you get 3 by 5 minus 9 by 2, which is equal to 6 minus 45 divided by 10, which is minus 39 by 10. Now this minus 39 by 10, is it a rational number? Yes, because minus 39 is an integer, 10 is an integer, and 10 is not equal to 0. So this is again a rational number. Now not only this, even if you consider 0 as one of the rational numbers, because we saw that the division property doesn't work for 0. So do you think that the subtraction property would work for 0? So let's say that one rational number is a and the other rational number is b. The other rational number b is 0. So in that case, a minus 0 would be 3 by 5 minus 0, which would be equal to 3 by 5. And 3 by 5 again is a rational number. So that means the closure property works for 0 as well. Now let's look at the closure property of multiplication. So here again, let us consider one rational number a as minus 6 by 9 and another rational number b as 1 by 3. So what would be a into b? So this would be minus 6 by 9 into 1 by 3. So this would come out to be minus 6 by 27. So when you look at it, minus 6 by 27, this is again a rational number. Now not only this example, you take any other example. For example, even if you consider 0, so let's say you have one rational number and the other number is 0. So in that case, it would be minus 6 by 9 into 0, and anything multiplied by 0 is always 0. So is 0 a rational number? Yes, because 0 is nothing but 0 by 1. And it satisfies the format of p by q. Therefore, 0 is a rational number. So the closure property of multiplication holds true for all rational numbers without any exception. Now let us come to the closure property of division, which doesn't hold true for all rational numbers. So let us first take an example where we take a is equal to 5 by 3 and b is equal to 1 by 2. So now we have to divide a by b. So that would be 5 by 3 divided by 1 by 2. So this will be equal to 5 by 3 into 2, which is equal to 10 by 3. So when you look at 10 by 3, this is in the form of p by q with q not equal to 0. So this is a rational number. But when you operate the same thing with 0, that is a divided by 0, so it becomes 5 by 3 divided by 0. And anything divided by 0 is not defined. And therefore, this is not rational. Now, since this doesn't hold true for 0, therefore, we can say that rational numbers are not closed under division. So the closure property works fine for addition, subtraction, and multiplication, but not for division. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com to avail free quality education with a simple 4-step learning process where you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology, along with practical videos. So what are you waiting for? Please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.